or that you can't. So the can't is, they're in the yard, they're running around, you call them, and the dog says, maybe later, I'm busy. Okay? So now what do you have to do? I'm telling you, you have to go get the dog and bring the dog to you. And what's the dog gonna do? Come and get me. And they start running around, and then now it becomes the game of chase. I don't know about you, but at this stage in my life, they win. Okay? So in that case, you don't use this voice. If you know the dog's over there, I have no way of really controlling him, don't use this voice. Just use, come on, let's go, whatever you want to do, whatever, however you chase him, whatever you do, get him, whatever. But when you use this voice, you have to follow through. And so the way we do it is we start on leash, practice in the house on leash, and a lot of people say, oh, well, he does it good in the house on leash. Good, keep it up, because we want this to become a conditioned response, which means he's so used to hearing, come, you know, right here, right now, and he comes over and you pat him and tell him he's great and you release him. It's so, he hears it so much and he does it so much that it just becomes automatic. He hears it, he comes, you pat him, you tell him he's great, and you release him to go do what he was doing most of the time. So, on leash in the house, on leash in the yard. When you go for walks, what a wonderful time to practice coming when called. So you walk for a while, and then at a certain point, you tell him to come. Now, don't do it if he's got his nose in something and he's really all of a sudden, you know, because you want to set him up for success. So if you, eventually he should do it no matter what's going on, right? But in the beginning stages, if he's really hung up on something, now you've got to break through that. So in the beginning stages, no. But when you're walking along and you see he's pretty cool, whatever, and he's just kind of walking, Rover, stop. Rover, right here, right now. He doesn't come, you bring him to you. What a good boy. Okie dokie, let's go. And you keep on walking. And a little while later, you do it again. And a little while later, you do it again. I mean, don't do it every 5 seconds, but, you know, throughout the walk. Eventually, what we do is, after you've done that a lot, and he seems to be understanding the game and cooperating, then we do the drag line, where in the house, let's say you say, okay, today I'm going to practice coming when called, but I'm not going to be on the other end of the leash. I have him on a drag line. And it can be a little thin chain or something if you don't want him chewing it up or whatever. And he's dragging this thing, and he's in the living room, and you say, Rover, right here, right now. And he says, maybe later, I'm busy, I'm chewing on a bone. Okay? So now I'm telling you, you have to go into the living room and get him. And so he sees you coming and he says, oh good, game of chase. And he starts to run around and you can put your foot on that drag line and you can get it. And you say, right here. Don't yell at him, don't be angry. Right here, low, slow voice. Take him into the kitchen where you were when you called him. Right here, let's go, right here, that's it. Take him in there. That's a good boy, what a good boy. Go back and join your phone. The more you call them to you, tell you how great they are, tell them how great they are, and then release them to go do what they were doing, they begin to feel that coming when called is not end of my fun, playtime is over. You know, you call them in from the yard and they say, I don't want to come in, I'm having fun out here, right? So they don't come when they're called because they're enjoying the outside. So what you do is you practice in the yard with a drag line eventually. Rover, right here, right now, they don't come, you go get them, you step on the thing, you bring them back to where you called them, you tell them how great they are, and then release them to go play again. And you just keep releasing them to go do what they were doing. Now, when you finally really need them to go in, okay, you're gonna call them over, what a good boy. This time you're gonna put the leash on, or have the leash. You're gonna walk around a little bit, and then you go in. So they don't really associate the coming when called with, oh, as soon as I go there, they're gonna make me go in the house. So we have our ways, but it's a slow process. For some dogs slower, for some dogs they're faster with this and they're more cooperative. Does that make sense?
No,
yeah. You gotta be careful, because like, treats are great, don't get me wrong, treats are wonderful, but you can get into trouble with treat training. So, remember I was saying that sometimes you reinforce behaviors you don't want. So let's say that the dog, one woman had a yellow lab that wouldn't walk. I mean, they would go out there and the lab would get to the end of the drive or whatever and would plop down and would not walk. Now, most people would interpret that as the dog is stubborn. The dog is stubborn, doesn't listen, won't go where we want him to go, he's stubborn, he just sits there. It's not stubborn. A yellow lab that doesn't want to go for a walk? Man, something's wrong here, right? Dogs do things for good reason. Rarely will a dog do something for just no reason at all, just because I want it and I'm going to be stubborn, you know. And a dog that says, yeah, I don't want to go for a walk, I mean, it just doesn't make sense. Usually when that happens, one of two things. Either the dog is afraid, because a lot of the younger dogs, they're afraid of traffic. Maybe they hear things in the neighborhood that you don't hear, coyotes. You know, they smell and hear all this stuff that you have no idea about. So they're like, uh-oh, there's something bad down there. I'm not going down there. Or dogs in the neighborhood, whatever. So either it's fear or it could be the dog is hurting. And as it turned out, when the dog would stop, they were pulling the dog along. And they would pull this dog for a couple of blocks, a block or two. And the dog would plop down again. And wind up is this dog did have a very serious problem that normally a dog that age wouldn't have had, but did have. Anyway, somebody said to them, oh, look, this is what you do. When they come out and they plop down, you get a treat and you lure them with the treat like this. And then they'll get up and then you give them the treat. So she did that. She said, now, she said, at least before I could drag him a block or two, now he sits down every 5 seconds. He sits, I give him the thing, we walk a couple of things, he sits down, I can't move him, So you gotta be careful when you're using treats, your timing, and exactly what are you reinforcing here, okay? So be aware of that. I'm not saying you can't use treats, but what I will tell you is don't use the big guns, save them for problem behaviors. Your dog is probably getting lots of different kinds of treats. Save the big things like cheese, pieces of chicken, you know, all those kinds of things that dogs love, you're probably giving them a whole lot of stuff. If you know your dog really loves chicken, use it as your ace up your sleeve when you have problem behaviors that need to be resolved. Because then, it's like, I'm getting fear aggressive with men. Every time a man comes in this house, I get cheese. Oh my God, these men come bearing cheese. I can't wait for the next guy to come. I get my eye teeth for cheese. So the cheese now becomes a good motivator, whereas if the dog always got cheese and chicken and everything you could possibly want, cheese kind of that all the time. So, you know, hold some things back. You never know when you need them. Questions? And if anybody needs to go, please do not feel like you're cemented to, or chained to the chairs. You really need to go, you go, okay? But if there are any other questions,
we don't have a fenced-in backyard yet. Eventually we will. Is it okay to put him, you know, the stake?
Yeah, you'll have to. You have to do something, right?
Okay.
So yeah, put the stake.
Just so I don't have to, I think I'm pretty patient, but sometimes when I want to pot a plant or something,
yes.
Put him on that.
Yes, and try to use a cable that has that plastic over
yes.
it so that he doesn't get all caught up in things.
Okay.
Okay, so next week you'll go to that other room and they'll direct you. And remember, don't let the dogs interact with each other. Let Glenn orchestrate everything that's going to go on in the class. And if you would like to stay right now, I am going to do, whether there's anybody in this room or not, if Kim's got time, and if not, we'll do it another day, talk to you about aggression. Okay? So those of you who need to go, please do. Please go.
I gotta go, but
sure.
So if you go far, you won't record it. Can I get a DVD of the aggression part?
You could. Yes.
But that's very important.
Yeah.
And I never got a coupon.
Thank you. Reminding me. Kim, do you have time, or
sure.
should we wait
yeah.
and do it?
No, that's fine.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm positive. Thank
okay.
You.
Oh, you're welcome.
Thank
you're welcome.
You.
I was talking about
the yes, I don't know if I have it on ready on a DVD.
I understand.
Yes,
you're
welcome. You
just turned six.
Oh, my goodness.
Is that turned off?
No.
You can turn it off.
Okay.